Hello everyone and welcome to my office tour slash setup tour, whatever you want to call it here for 2021. A long time coming, moved into a new house, new office. Let's get started. I'm going to turn on the lights here and we'll start at the PC and work our way all the way around the room. All right, we're going to start on the left side of the room. When you walk in the door to my office, got a trash can here and you are greeted with the main setup here. That's got the PC. You know, the desk and all that stuff, key lights, the camera I use, the Sony A6400. I'm gonna go into all of that detail one by one and move our way around the office all the way to my racing rig, where I will there show you in detail what that's all about, some of my trinkets and collectibles here, and then moving on to some more pieces that I use for flight simulation and stuff, and the good old GTA 5 map and a Boeing 727 window that Barry Bugs got me a long time ago. So let's start on the left-hand side. You can see we've got a Rode PSA, I think it's the 100, I forget the name of it actually, the arm here, and it just kind of, you know, screws in underneath there. Nice little desk mount to it, comes up and around, and here is the RE20, the Electric Voice RE20. This is my main microphone. I've been using it for many, many, many years. 2016 is when I got it, and I have never changed since then. I'll explain as we go on. here's the chair. So I used a DX Racer for a while, and that wasn't working out. Now, this chair here was the biggest purchase disappointment I've ever made in my life. Now, it was the autonomous Ergo Chair 2, whatever you want to call it, but it's actually the Mio Chair, which is junk. So you can see down here, I've done the best I could, and I've used some good old fashioned bungee cords to keep the back from falling back on you constantly, because I don't know what they thought in design, how that would be a good idea. So to keep good posture, I'm doing that. This thing's junk. It's not worth the money at all. So I am probably gonna end up trashing this thing and getting something nice down the road. So left-hand side here, you see how the microphone here is connected, goes all the way down and around, and behind here, you can see we've got a cloud lifter. This guy right there. Yeah, the cloud lifter. That is the signal booster, and that goes in all the way around into the Go XLR. That's what I use for all of my audio, including the software in the on the PC as well. That's how I do all my post everything. So it does it in real time. It does your compression, your EQ, you know, you name it, noise gate. So for lighting, I've got the key lights, the Elgato key lights. Now, I don't use a whole lot of Elgato stuff anymore. I'm not sponsored by them or anything like that. I just like the key lights, that's for certain. But let's start on the left-hand side here. I'm getting a little ahead of myself. And here is the 100,000 subscriber plaque for Fabiano Live. If you don't know what Fabiano Live is, that is my Twitch archive channel on YouTube. If a video is good enough, I will throw it up on there. Thank you guys so much for the support of that. That was absolutely crazy how fast we reached that goal. Without even, I didn't even see it coming, honestly. And then here's the 1 million subscriber plaque. You know, that's something super, super special to me. Thank you all so much for getting me there. I did a unboxing of all that stuff back in the day when that came through. And here they are. So I've also got another one back here. We'll get to that in a second. That's the original one for the main channel. I don't think it's going to zoom into it. Yeah, we'll try to get over there in a minute. So I use the LG... not sure the actual name of the monitor. It's a gaming monitor, 144 Hz. I love it. I use a Corsair keyboard. It's just always red, so it's not RGB at all, unfortunately. This is a piece of TrackIR. So TrackIR is what I, you know, freely look around in simulation games. This clips onto the side of the actual headset I'm using, and then it looks at this little guy right there. That is the TrackIR. Infrared camera. So that's how I am able to do that. So we'll get to the back here in a second. Got the Stream Deck here ready to go. That could, right now it's controlling the Elgato key lights and stuff. And then this beauty right here. That is the one. Hello. That is the A6400, the Sony A6400 is my main face cam that I use for everything right there. Now the camera I'm using currently to show you this video with is that one right up there. I have two of them. That's in Sony AX53. That is the one I use to shoot all the wheel cam stuff. So we'll get to that in a second here. But that's what I wanted to show you. And you can see cable management is brought to you by my lovely wife, Nicole. She did an awesome job of making this rat's nest into something a little more, you know, approachable. That's for certain. She did that when I was just out of town recently. She actually remodeled most of my entire office. And wow, she did such an incredible job. It was a surprise. And I came home, I was like, this, I love this. So I'm doing a setup tour like now because of this. So these are all the hard drives, external hard drives. You can imagine, you know, USB hub back here. We got all of our power running in here. I know some people be like, what do you call that, cable management? Well, for me, it's good enough, you know. And then moving to the back of the PC here. If you want to know any of the specs of the PC, check out the About page on YouTube. It'll be right there. It'll tell you everything you need to know. Like I said, go XLR. You see, that's where the actual microphone plugs in right there. And that's all I use, just that. The cloud lifter, and then straight out to the actual microphone. So pretty amazing, pretty simplified. You can't go wrong with it. And by the way, that turbo looking thing there, that is the TSPC Razor wheel that I use. That's the power supply for it, which is, it's actually like modeled after a turbo. That's the reason why you might have seen that back there. Then up here, got some pictures and some trinkets. Then we have the main clock. I can jump into a stopwatch mode or anything I want to. I can go up, so it's zero. And then when you click it, boom. Now I know how long I've been live. Click it again, it's done. And then you go back to clock. So 6:19 is what the current time is right there. That's what it's showing. And here's the awesome Jetline PC, Jetline Systems PC. They have sponsored my channel for quite a few years and they make all my PCs. They didn't want me to make a video on this one though, even though it is custom. You see how beautiful that is? I love the JF. I need to get in there and get rid of some of this stuff. This stuff's, yeah, starting to get a little nasty there. Have to take care of that, no problem. I use the GeForce RTX 2080. I don't have a 30 series card yet. And then that's the Elgato HDMI little guy there for the, what do they call it, the Camlink Pro or whatever. That's how I run all my cameras in for live streams. Then down below, we've got a USB hub right there. You can see that's what everything plugs into whenever I plug in all my stuff for American Truck Sim. I just kind of roll that whole assembly there, the Next Level Racing GT track, right over here into position. I'll show you how that works here in a bit. Corsair mouse. Not sure what the model is on it. Just a Corsair mouse. And this is a Razer mouse pad. And I do things a little bit different than a lot of people. When I'm sitting here playing like GTA or something with a controller, set things down, this is how I have my mouse set up. And whenever I'm driving, I have my mouse set up over here. Some people don't like that. I've actually learned to just get along with it, and I like to use my mouse pad on this side right here. It's weird, I know, but it works for me. My main controller choice right here is the Thrustmaster eSwap Pro here, as you can see. It is fantastic. Thanks to Thrustmaster for sending this thing in, obviously. It has replaced my actual Xbox One controller I was using before. That one right up there. But that's my main one I'm using right now for our, all the GTA stuff. And anything that requires a gamepad is what I use right there. So, right there, Jetline Systems. Thank you guys so much for such a beautiful PC and keeping me going over the years, man. I got a UPS down there, so that keeps the power going even whenever you get a power outage here. That is pretty frequent here in Florida, so that's how everything is plugged in right there. It's better, like, believe me, this was, like, terrible down there, so big thanks to Nicole for doing that. This is the secondary PC right now, just not being used. This is the one that one replaced, so I'm going to find a home for that probably out in the living room and make that into an entertainment center out there for the most part. I thought I was going to use it for a streaming PC, but I really have no need to use it right now. So my headphones of choice right here, Sony MDR7506s, and a lot of people go, you need to get good headphones or whatever. The 7506s are flat EQ, so I can actually EQ my audio and stuff correctly through headphones instead of having to use monitors. That's why I use it. And the sound quality is absolutely amazing. They're only $99. Netgear router right here. I had to go out and purchase that because the one that came with my Frontier is the name of the company that does the gigabit internet. There it is right there. Coming in the line right there. Full fiber line, and like 900 something up, 900 something down. Absolutely amazing. Drilled right into there off of the terminals. So I had to go out and get that because the one that they provided was garbage. Here is my VR headset. It is a Reverb G2. I use that for like DCS flying stuff and some other things. Those are the controllers for the Reverb G2. Moving up here, you see some more trinkets we got around the backside of this guy here. This is the lens that came with it. It wasn't what I was looking for. This is the Sony lens that came with the actual A6400. Now, I ended up coming over here and I grabbed a Sigma 30mm, and it is amazing. It has a 1.4 f-stop on it, as you can see right there. Look at that. And it lets in so much light. It looks so good, and it does a nice, beautiful bokeh and everything around. Absolutely love that camera. Worth it, 100%. Moving on, there it is right there, the A6400. Same camera I'm using right now to film this with. You can see on the back side there, it goes down. And then I have a cable here that runs into the back of the PC, into that Camlink Pro, and that powers the cam for doing live streams. That's all that's for, honestly. Then we have over here the closet. Open this up. Here we are right here. Got some Thrustmaster rims in here. This is my other main, my racing one I use, the Sparco R383 rim. Fantastic. Love that little guy. That's the one that came with my TSPC racer. I purchased my own TSPC racer. They never sent me that back in the day, and still have it and still use it today. It's my favorite. This one here is coming soon. That's all I can say. If you know what that is, you know what that is. You're going to see a video on this thing very, very, very soon. It is beautiful. Bunch of stuff up here. Handbrake and all that kind of stuff. I got my VirtuaFly Vernio. A little throttle and all that stuff there. And then these are my main ones I use. The TPRs for flight simulation. This is an old Oculus box there. My Rift S is in there. And then over here, that's the T248 I was using recently, and that campaign ended, so that is actually going to find a home to one of you guys soon. And then I've got my Mooseletoe from back in the day when I was a kid. It is still with me. How you doing, Mooseletoe, down there? Doing good? Yep. And Nicole brought him back to life with antlers and stuff because they got ripped off over the many, many years. That thing is, like, super old. And then I have my next level racing stand for the monitor when I eventually would like to put it up over here in the corner or something, but as of right now, I'm not doing that. Then we got the TQ6 by VirtuaFly. Use that sometimes. There's that Sony A6400 box, like I said. Some drawers for some junk here. You can never have too much junk, right? Believe it or not, still have the old Focusrite Scarlett. Don't use it anymore, but it's not broken, so we still have it on standby if need be. Some guitar stuff. That's an Elgato green screen there, luggage for whenever I go flying and go traveling. And then the Grand Theft Auto 5 poster I've had for many, many, many years right there. So let's move out of the closet and move on with our lives, shall we? This is my Roland V-Drums here. For those of you that don't know, I've been playing drums for many, 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 many years, longer than any other instrument. Play guitar as well. That's an acoustic bass there. I forget what company makes that. It was a real cheap one. I got all Best Choice Products. Yeah, I got this thing on Amazon for like $75, and it's awesome. It just sounds pretty darn good. Then the Ibanez, gotta have that. We've got my original Dreadnought acoustic guitar, a Washburn. You can even see the tuning pegs are missing on that guy. Yeah, got that a long time ago. Still have that one. It's one of my first guitars. And then my new one I got is the Taylor, the C615 CE. I'm still new to the Taylor family. Don't crucify me too much there. Got some up lights here for the background whenever we're using the face cam. My Roland Juno DS, you've seen that in a few vlogs and stuff in the past. I do play piano and keyboards, so that's what all that is about. Roland V drums right there, like I said. Moving on, we're not going to get into this because I'm going to pull it out and show you a little bit more into detail. And moving on, we got blackout curtains, so it's completely blacked out in here whenever I want it to be. And then here's the original 100,000 subscriber plaque back in the day, right there. The old classic. And then we have the letter from Susan right there as well. Really, really cool stuff, man. And then here's my prized possession. It's not very expensive at all. I got this in 2009. This is a Fender Strat, but it's a Mexican Strat. And I kind of just did it up to look like David Gilmour's for the most part. I even did some magic marker on the edge of a black little pick guard there. You can see the shoddy workmanship right there on the edge. Need to change out the strings on that, but I still use it a lot. Another uplight right there. Moving on, we've got my E-Flight Apprentice S RC airplane. Had quite a few flights with that thing, and I never crashed it, so that's good so far. Back in the day, a subscriber named Kyle got me these F-18s, the Blue Angels. You've seen them in previous setup tours before. They're still here with me today. Moving on, we have a custom JF Xbox One controller. That was by Controller Chaos out of St. Louis. They did an amazing job. If you ever want to get a custom controller, I highly recommend these guys. They really went above and beyond with that. That looks so good. I don't ever want to use it because I don't want to mess it up. Thrustmaster 250 GTO wheel. Got that guy there. And then we've got the Sparco. It's like a D-shaped one, as you see there. It's another rally racing rim. I've got that guy. This is the controller for my R2-D2. And it's kind of my travel little shelf here. Got a bunch of stuff. Got, you know, the shuttle and police car. Belize when we were on a cruise and stuff. Been to, you know, Southernmost Point there in Key West. And then there's R2-D2 from the Droid Depot. I have that. Needs a control. It's pretty awesome. And then we move on to some other stuff up here. That's good old Walter White, because everybody thinks that, you know, when I shave my head, I'm Walter White. So there you go. Dave got me that for Christmas one year. Then I have my little small drones there. And then there is my blazer. The, what's it called? A Vatera. Oh, man. The Vatera Ascender, I think is what it is. It's been a while. Then you have a air freshener there. Then my airplane collection here. So we got a Southwest 737-800 here. The Heart 1, actually, as you can see right there. Pretty darn cool. And there's the little Scimitar winglet. Moving on into the middle, this one is the brand new one that was just given to me by Christian at Flight Sim Expo. He came up to me and gave me this as a gift. It's the MAX, the 737 MAX 8. And you can tell by the, not only the new engine, you know, the new style engines there, but also the winglets as well. Look at those, the MAX winglets. Really cool to have that added to the collection. And thank you so much, Christian. Here it is. At home. Then I have the Missouri 1 because I'm from Missouri originally, so gotta have the Missouri 1. If you haven't noticed, Southwest is my favorite airline. Moving on, Continental 747-200, Kitty Hawk 727-200. That is the company I used to, you know, do a contract for when I worked in air cargo, and that is the airplane. An F-16 that my buddy Timmy got me a while back. And I got a DHL 727-200. That was another airplane I worked on back in the day. An F-15 clock my mom got me from Boeing. And then moving on, we have the Texas one, only, or the Lone Star one, sorry. Only because I'm not from Texas or anything. I just love the look of this little 700 in those colors. So that's my airplane collection for the most part. My NASCAR collection is pretty pitiful. We'll get to that in a second, but here's my Overwatch collection. Got Mercy, Lucio. You got Tracer, love. Then you've got McCree. You got Farah back there. Reinhardt's right here in the front. So on and so forth. If you don't know what Overwatch is, it's the Blizzard game. Got a Pachimari there. That's the only Lucio I have there. And then that is a Lego that my buddy Timmy got me. Lego set of Mr. Wrecking Ball, the hamster himself. And then I have my D.Va little neon light there. So I'm a huge Overwatch fan. Maybe some of you guys don't know that. I play that game probably as much as any other game, to be honest with you. So down here's some diecast NASCAR things from a while back. Got Brad Keselowski, got Martin Truex Jr. whenever he won a championship. Kurt Busch of that year. And then I just stopped collecting. I don't have anything new. I need to get some new stuff here as well. That's a lug nut from one of the races. That is whenever I went to Gateway and did 50 laps in that actual car right there. So I have actually raced a real race car with a Rusty Wallace Racing Experience, as you see right there. Pretty darn cool, right? Yes, and look at that. Look at that happy person after getting out of that car. Yeah, that was incredible. There's some stuff down here. It's the rail driver I use for train sim. right there. And then the left-hand side just got the Ferrari, the cheaper Ferrari rim, Thrustmaster rim. And then I have some controllers for my Vitara and for the Apprentice as well. Moving on, here it is, the TCA whole throttle quadrant for Airbus by Thrustmaster. Use this all the time. And also the desk mount for it. This is a Fox mount that clips onto the desk right there. And that comes down and around, and I've actually mounted this manually with my ASP heavy hauler you have seen in American Truck Sim videos by ASP. Fantastic button box. The only issue I ever had is the fuel button right there finally gave up the ghost and died. So still works fine. No problems there. Got the HOTAS 1 there that was for the recent campaign. I'll be giving that away. Then we've got my Yoko Yoke by Virtual Fly. That is my main yoke as of now. It's a fantastic yoke. It's highly expensive, but it's fantastic, honestly. Then the good old Thrustmaster Warthog. That is the throttle quadrant there. Some trinkets and nonsense there because, you know, when you have all this crap, you have to constantly, you know, work on it. Then I've got my Airbus side stick here, TCA side stick by Thrustmaster. I got an Airbus bellow from a cockpit building site. Put that on there. These are the TP, what is it, 3Ms? I forget what these all these acronyms I tell you. Those are the ones that were part of the T248. So, fantastic set of pedals, honestly, with that T248. I was pretty impressed. And then I used my TLCMs. Let me pull this guy out, and then we're going to go over that. So as you can see, I can just push on this guy, and it just rolls because it's all on wheels. And this is the GT track, the whole shebang here. Here's the TSPC racer I use, and that is the right here. You see how the ecosystem kind of comes together here, and then I have the button little backing piece for the 499, whatever that is, one of the other rims I had in the thing. It was the 599 XX Evo. I know it's a Ferrari rim, but I took that off, put a Rickmotech adapter on it, and then this is the NRG Innovations 18-inch wooden wheel that attached to it from there. So that's a TSPC racer I've had since about 2016 or so. Yeah, I believe so. Still going strong. It's my main workhorse. I love it. And those are those TLCM pedals that we've done videos on before. You've seen it. And then we have all this fun stuff. Got the, you know, seat belts and stuff for when you're using the motion rig. And you can see the wear and tear of this thing over the years. I've got a rip here, pretty good size one. I poked the actual metal piece back down in there. That one, and then I have a little rip, you know, some stuff happening right here where it's starting to go. It's just all seat stuff. I use this a lot. And with motion, you know, you're constantly moving around and rubbing and stuff. It's going to happen. But I wanted to show you guys that that is definitely a thing with this particular seat. We'll get a hold of them and let them know about it and see if maybe they'll replace it. I don't know. Moving on here. We've got, I'm doing this all in one foul sweep, guys. I'm trying to keep this all together for us. This is the TH8A. Shifter from Thrustmaster, and that is on a 10-inch extension rod from Southern Trucker Gaming, and that attaches onto there, and this is the Southern Trucker Gaming actual Eaton Fuller 18-speed. This thing is a beast. It's actually made of the real deal. As you can see the Eaton right there, uses the real parts, and then just kind of swaps them out and makes them into an actual game controller. How cool is that? So it does exactly what the real one does. Pretty darn cool. Moving around here, we're gonna get down to the bottom and towards the end of this entire video. Right here is the motion platform right there, the motion platform V3. You see it right down there, attached to the seat. And that is how motion is done. I just plug in that little cord right there, right into that guy when I move this thing into its position right there. And I have motion just like that. All right, guys, that's going to do it for this video of the whole setup tour. If you have questions, you can always leave them below in the comments. Like I said, go to the About page and you can check out the actual stuff that's inside of my PC if you want to know about that. But that's how I'm doing everything here in 2021. I'll see you guys next time. Take care.
Well, I don't have to say anything about finding the merch store. You guys have done it. Thank you so much for all the love and support. I truly appreciate it. And I have an awesome collab with another company coming soon. So stay tuned for that. Anywho, thank you. See you next time.